aircraft manufacturer Bombardier Commercial could consider investing in Africa by establishing a maintenance center. If the request expressly met by the Minister for Works and Transport, Monica Azuba, before the Bombardier team at the handover of the aircraft to Uganda is anything to go by. It's regarded essential, especially that now the only aircraft type, CRJ900, possessed by Uganda on the entire African continent.
At last, the moment awaited with pomp was here for Uganda officially to take delivery of our very first aircraft from the Canadian manufacturer Bombardier at the production center in Quebec, Mirabel, Canada. The momentous occasion, which awakens the pride the country last had about 20 years ago, was concretized by putting pen to paper officially, transferring the deed to Uganda Airlines on behalf of the airline undertaken by the Permanent Secretary, Ministry of Works and Transport, Waswa Bageya, and Fred Comer, the president of Bombardier, on behalf of the manufacturer. For many gathered here, it was spellbinding coming this close to the aircraft sold by Bombardier as CRJ900 Atmosphere and the first of the kind on the African soil. Is this the kind of the aircraft you expected?
Yeah, definitely. This is the kind of aircraft that was shown to us in the pictures right before last year. And what we saw then is what we are seeing now. But now the feel is even much better.
Okay. Legacy space is quite good and enough. Even in the economy, it's quite wide enough.
It is beautiful, but I believe this is going to encourage regional tourism.
With about 4 flight hours amassed during the test flight exercises, Uganda Airlines Chief Pilot Captain Michael Etiang couldn't agree any less with Bombardier's president as regards the novelty of this aircraft.
Designed the CRJ900 for excellent cost efficiency and network flexibility, and are confident that the CRJ900 will contribute to Uganda Airlines' growth and success. Since its launch, the CRJ series family of regional jets has led to the development of regional markets around the world. The CRJ has revolutionized aviation with proven efficiency, reliability, and profitability.
This aircraft has only done a flight test, which was part of the requirements for the company accepting it. Yeah? And as such, this aircraft barely has 5 hours, this and the other one. So I want to reassure this is a brand new aircraft. You can see for yourself where we are. This is a factory.
This CRJ900 aircraft is a 76-seater, configured into business with 12 seats and economy, 64 seats.
Class has 12 seats and large overhead bins. These are larger than earlier models and allow for wheels in first placement of your bags. Ample space at par with other aircraft in this class. And seats that are comfortable enough for the larger size public out there. I'm modestly weighted, but I sit comfortably here. Of course, there are people with larger bellies, and they'll be comfortable too.
Being the first of its kind on the continent, critics have pointed out that it may turn out to be difficult to maintain. But the Minister Zubantege sees an opportunity here.
Operation of CRJ900 is a new experience for Uganda Airlines. It will need your continuous support to enhance competitiveness of the CRJ900 in Africa. Therefore, you should consider developing a maintenance and training facility in the region. I can confirm that Uganda would be very happy to partner with you in developing such a facility for the use of Uganda Airlines and other airlines in the region. We are ready to discuss and conclude with you the modalities of the establishment of such a facility in none other than Uganda.
Pilots scheduled to fly the aircraft already registered by the Civil Aviation Authority as 5XKOB and 5XEQU start the journey on Saturday 19th through Iceland, Netherlands, Greece and Cairo in Egypt before final leg to Uganda with touchdown and water salute activities at Entebbe International Airport expected on Tuesday at 3 p.m.
Okay. This aircraft shall serve Uganda coffee and matoke
Bombardier has an order for two other aircraft planned for delivery in July, a period set for the commencement of the commercial flights, and the last one in September same year.
After all has been said, people have talked, but now words have turned into action, and this today has been a statement by Ugandan government showing that it is serious about the revival of a national airliner. Onyango Jackson, reporting for UBC TV from Canada.